Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Civil with Sudhir. So today in this video we are discussing about the doors and windows. It is a class 17 of building material and construction. If you want to see the previous videos, please click on the I button just above this video, so you will get the previous video, as well as go to our channel and you can see the playlist. I have made a playlist as an SSC JE or KPSC AEJE. And please like, comment and share this video, as well as subscribe this channel. And if you want to join Telegram channel, please go to the Telegram and search in the name Civil with Sudhir, and you can join the Telegram channel. So let's begin, friends. Today's video is doors and windows. We will discuss so why we provide the doors and windows, as well as the content and the types and some recommendation, as well as the sizes of the doors and windows. Yes, so first of all, you must understand why we require the doors and windows in our buildings or in our structures. So doors and windows we provide for ascending or descending, or for the movement of for a room, right? And windows we provide for light, as extra light, as well as the air, right? When the door is closed, so if we require the light as well as air, so we will use the windows. So this is about the doors and windows, right? So doors yak provide matti matte windows. So now the location of doors and windows, where we have to provide the doors and windows. Number of doors and windows should be minimum. Number of doors and windows should be minimum. So it should not be greater, or it for example, in a single room you can't provide more than the area we can decide. So that much area only you have to provide the what, windows as well as doors. Windows as well as doors not at the center, provide at the corners, nearly 20 centimeter away from the corner. So you can't provide the windows or doors at the corner. It should be away from the 20 centimeter. Next one is size and number of doors and windows based on light control on ventilation. So number of doors, how many number of doors you require, as well as windows, based on the purpose of light and the type of room functions. For example, if you are providing in doors and windows for kitchen, how much light you required, how much doors you require, you have to decide. Then you have to decide the size of the doors as well as windows. Windows location should follow interior decoration. One minute. Yes, so windows location should follow interior decoration, right? And the furniture arrangement. So what type of windows you will provide, that window will follow the interior decoration as well as furniture arrangement. Wahan pe furniture or interior decoration karne ke liye kuch usse windows ya door se humko interior arrangement karne ke liye kuch takleef nahi hona chahiye wahan pe. To aisa humko windows or doors provide karna chahiye. Windows and doors provide in opposite direction in two doors or windows. So they must be, either it may be opposite if you are providing two different doors and windows. That, and one more point I will discuss here. So if you are providing a window at the room, right, it should be 1/10 of the room area. 1/10. It should be 1/10 of the room area. So this is also a very important point. So now we have some doors terms in doors and windows, right? This is a panel door, right? First of all, understand some terms in the doors as well as windows. We will discuss later. So the first of all, we will discuss about the doors. See, this is frame. First of all, understand this is outskirt, or we can say this is a outward. First, they will place this one. This we call it as frame or casing. They are saying casing, okay? So after that, so this total assembly we call it as door, right? And only this portion we call it as shutter. Only this portion we call it as shutter. Now in this shutter also we have there is some different styles also. This is the one vertical style, and here also one, and here also, as well as we have some rails. That is, this is top rails, this is lock rail, this is bottom rail, right? So these rails will help these these rails will help to fix these panels. So these are the panels, these are the panels. We have total 1, 2, 3, and 4. So these are the 4 panels. It may be 4 panels, 2 panels, or 6 panels, depends on the requirement and the height of the door, height of the door. So this middle portion we call it as mullion, and these are the panels, and this is top rail, this one is top rail, right? And this is lock style or style, and this one at the mid portion, this one we call it as lock rail, and here there is a locking arrangement for closing the door. And next one at the bottom, it is bottom rail, and this is the saddle or threshold, right? And sometimes it will provide like this, then extra portion of door, sorry, frame will provide. This one we call it as horn, H-O-R-N. This one we call it as horn, H-O-R-N. So this is about some terms in doors and windows. And we have some hinges also here. This shutter completely attached to this frame using some hinges, right? Hinges. This is jamb, right? This is jamb portion. We can say the inside of frame, inside face of the frame, that we call it as jamb. Okay. Next one is the types of doors. So what are the different types of doors? We'll discuss now. First one, battened ledge and frame doors, framed panel doors, glazed or slash doors. It should be slash doors. Flush door, revolving door, sliding door, swing door or swinging door we can say, collapsible steel door, and rolling steel shutter door. All these type of doors we will discuss in this video and with the sketches. First one, battened and ledge door. So in this type of door, it is made up of vertical boards known as battens. So these are the battens, vertical, you can see these are the battens here also and here also. So it is made up of vertical boards known as battens. So battens को जो है यहाँ पे जो है horizontal support जो देता है उसको हम ledges बोलते हैं. First of all क्या करता है, ऐसा vertical members, ऐसा battens को place करके इस battens को ऐसे horizontally जो provide करते हैं उसको हम ledges बोलते हैं. These are ledges and these are battens. Okay, and you can provide here the locking arrangement also, right? And here they will attach with the again hinges, you can attach with the hinges, and this is provided with the frame like this. They will provide with the frame like this. They will provide. So this is the batten and ledge door. This is nowadays this is offset, this one type of is not using. So battens are 100 mm to 150 mm wide. These battens are 100 mm to 150 and 20 to 30 mm thick. Thickness is 20 to 30. Three ledges are provided at top, bottom and middle. So one top, middle and bottom. Right, top, middle and at the bottom also there is an ledges. Okay, this is about the first one, ledges, battened and ledge door. Next is, okay, this type of door you can see in the villages, right? So battened ledge and braced door, battened ledge and braced door. You can see this is a frame. First of all, understand this is frame, right? And these are the braces. These are the braces. This is brace. This one also a brace. So in this type of door, diagonal members known as braces. So these are the braces or diagonal members are provided. Right, first point. Braces are 100 mm to 150 mm wide. So okay, the width of this brace is 100 to 150 mm wide and 30 mm thick. The thickness of this brace is 30 mm. Braces give rigidity to the door. It will give rigidity to the door. And these braces are attached to these horizontal members. This type of door useful for wide openings, right? So the wide openings, where the wide openings are there, right, that in that condition this type of door will be used. So braces should be slope upwards as they act like in compression, not in tension. So this should be at the top, means this one should be placed on this. This is at the bottom and this one is like this. This is first and you have to apply like this, first and second. This is at the top, not at the bottom. If you provide at the bottom, it will act like a tension. So we have to apply this in a compression, not in tension, right? This is about the batten and ledge and brace doors. Next is framed and panel doors. Framed and panel doors, you can see in the sketch. So this is the top rail, you can see this like this, there is in the frame will come like this, and this frame will come like this. Yes, okay. So the frame will come like this, just adjust it, right? Now this is a top rail and this is middle rail, this is bottom rail, we can say this is also a locking rail. So at the center point we have one style, at the corners also you have style, at the this side also you have styles, and here also, and here also, and here also. So this is top rail, we can say this is a freeze rail, lock rail and bottom rail. In between these we call it as, this one is freeze rail, freeze rail, freeze rail, okay, freeze rail. So it consists of framework in which panels are fitted. So these are the panels, these are the different panels are fitted. It consists of rails to connect panels in position. So it consists of rails, right? This is top rail, it consists of this one to support the panels. Thickness of the shutter is 30 mm to 40 mm. So this thickness, the whole shutter thickness should be 30 to 40 mm. Thickness of panel is 20 mm. This panel thickness, right? The panel will look like this. Right? So this thickness is, we call it as 20 mm. So this type of door is nowadays everywhere using, and it is very common to construct as well as easy to cast, right? Next is glazed or sash door. So in order to admit, you can see in the sketch, half glazed and half panel, we can say this type of door, we call it as half glazed and half panel, because half they have used wooden and half it is in glass. In order to admit more light in addition to that coming from the window, right? If you want more light inside your building, then this type of door they will provide at the inside of the building, not at the outside. Sometimes they will provide at the entrance also, but this is not allowed. There is some safety issue if you use this glass type, right? You have to use the indoor only. Fully glazed or partly paneled. Fully glazed means this also is in glass, or partly paneled and partly glazed. This one is partly paneled and partly glazed. Doors are used. So glazing ratio is 2:1, means the glazing ratio, it should be 2:1. It is useful for hospital, offices, libraries, showrooms, banks and shopping units, right? So it is used where offices, libraries, showrooms, banks, shopping units, where the indoor doors are provided, right, and you require an extra light ventilation. So explanation of this door, you can see there is an window here, right, a small window, or we can say this is a slash door with here also, but this is a part of the door only, right? This is a part of the door only. Next is flush door. The difference between this flush door and glazed or sash door is, ये दोनों में common एक ही है, ये ready-made है, these are the ready-made doors, ये जहाँ पे आप companies या factories में manufacture होके directly standard size में manufacture होके आता है, this will be having the own standard size. Directly you have to take the door, right, and you have to fix where you require, like that. So you have that type of door is plus doors. So this type of doors nowadays they are providing at what we can say in the bathrooms as well as for the internal rooms, right? And it having two types, framed flush door and laminated flush door. It means either in this portion you can use the glass or it is fully paneled, right? Paneled means you have to use the wood or plywood. And the thickness of the flush door is from 25 to 40 mm. It is used for interior work. It is completely we can use for the interior work, not for external, because strength is okay, strength is good, but it is easily attacked by rainwater. It can easily attack by rainwater. This is very very important point about the flush door. Okay, next one is revolving door. Okay, to understand revolving door, first of all you should just seeing the sketch you can understand everything. So there is a center pivot here. So it I will take the pen. It consists of centrally placed mullion or pivot in circular opening. So this is an circular opening, right, at the center, right, at the center. This is an pivot or an point. It is attached, and this is attached with this one, the revolving shutters. These are the shutters, right? These are the revolving shutters. These are the revolving shutters are attached to the pivot, and shutters may be fully glazed. These are the fully glazed. Central pivot are provided with ball bearing at bottom. Ball bearing at the bottom and bush bearing at the top for smooth rotation. It will rotate in this direction, right? So where one person, if they want to exit, another person can enter. So it will behave like an exit and enter at the same time. If one person is going to exit, ek jan agar bahar ja raha hai to aur ek aadmi andar aa sakte hai, right? So it can enter and it can exit at the same time. This is one of the major advantage. So this type of doors are provided where there is heavy traffic, like big hotels, banks, offices, theaters and hospitals, right? So very very important one, just remember, because in the exams sometimes they may ask for revolving door where we will use, and they will give the option, so you have to remember. Sliding door. For sliding door, you can see nowadays sliding door as well as sliding windows also came. So easy to installation as well as this type of door is used when you require an extra ventilation from your balcony or from your courtyard, from your veranda, right? You can say this is a bedroom, right? So this is at the outside of this bedroom, there is a veranda at this opposite side. So you can provide this type of sliding doors at the verandas or where you required for extra ventilation, right? Very very important. Next one, collapsible steel door. Collapsible steel door. To understand this, just you can seeing the sketch you can understand. And this type of doors is only provided for safety purpose, right? Safety purpose. It is mostly used for all type of market shops as well as banks where the safety is required, right? So in that conditions this will use. So how we can just explain by seeing this one. Top track, this is a track. We can just using this handle, you can just bring this one here. It will, when you push here, it will behave like this. It will look like this, right? So this is a track, and so this is an integrated lock. Vertical pickets. So these are the vertical pickets, is nothing but it will some pipe like structure, right? When you cut the section, you can see like this in the U shape. In the U shape it will look, right? So it will look like this when you see, right, this one. okay. And next is diagonal letters. This is a diagonal lattice and easy glide wheels. There is a wheels at the bottom. There is a wheels at the bottom for rolling purpose. If you push this one, it will go in this direction. If you push this one, it will go in the backward as well as forward direction. This is very, very important. And easy glide wheels, bottom track. This is a bottom track. And this is the total height. And this is bunching. We call it as this is bunching. Total width. Okay, this type of door we use for safety purpose. Next is rolling steel shutter door. And this type of all doors we use in shops, mainly in the marketing shops, where there is a drum at the inside room. And this is the front elevation. You are standing here, my students are standing here and watching this, right? So you are watching in this direction. So this is at the inside of the room, right? So this is a support bracket. This is support bracket. So when you push this up, it will rotate in this direction, and it will 1 minute. So it will what? 1 minute. Pen. So when you push this one up, right, it will rotate and it will join like this in the drum. Okay, ये ऐसे ही rotate होके उसको क्या है roll हो जाता है, right? उसको door step भी यहाँ पे है और tempered spring, यहाँ पे spring रहता है. जैसे ही आप इसको push करेंगे नीचे, यहाँ पे lock कर देंगे तो वो lock हो जाएगा, right? So एक्सेल असेंबली भी रहेगा. वर्टिकल गाइड्स फॉर स्टील और वुड जम्प से ईजी है, जस्ट आप देखने के बाद भी अंडरस्टैंड कर लेते हैं, ठीक है? तो ये शॉप्स को यूज करते हैं इस टाइप के डोर्स को. सो दिस इज अ फ्रंट साइड. सो दिस इज एन रोलिंग शटर ड्रम एट द फ्रंट साइड. सॉरी. नेक्स्ट इज साइज ऑफ द डोर्स एज पर IS रिकमेंडेशन. Size of the doors as per IS recommendation. So when we have so sizes of the doors, we can by seeing the different conditions, just we can decide. So by seeing this condition, we can decide. So size of the doors as per the IS recommendations. So as per the IS recommendations, we can say the entrance, that we call it as the D1, where the size of the doors is maximum. So this is shutter size and this is masonry opening. Shutter size means this is door size and this is the opening size, 1200 × 2100 mm. These all the sizes are in mm. Okay, and for the D2 also 1100 × 2100. For the internals, this is the dimension, and for the for rooms, 800 × 2045, 900 × 2100 mm, 2.1 meter we can say. For kitchen and store, 800 × 2.45 meter, or 0.9 × 2.1 meter. For toilet and bath, you can say the shutter size is reduced, that is 0.6 meter. So as per our requirement, we have to decide the size of the doors. Okay. Next is type of windows. We'll discuss very in short. So panel or glazed window, bay window, French window, dormer window, pivoted window, corner window, gable window. So all these we will discuss with the sketch. First of all, paneled and glazed window. In the panel and glazed window, you can see. So this is the what we can say. This is frame at the bottom as well as this is. So this portion we call it as sill. Bottom portion of the window we call it as sill. And these are the some supports we can say, and this one is panel. This is panel. This is fully glazed window. This is fully glazed window. If you want half panel, half glazed, so you can use the bottom portion as a panel and top portion as a glazed, right? And there is a mullions as well as some grill also. So this type of windows are used where you required for ventilation purpose in the different buildings. Next is bay window. In the bay window, this window project outside the external walls of a room. You can see the in the sketch you can see. So wall is here, it came just outside of the room, right? When we see from the top, this is wall, but the window will come like this, right? The window will come like this. So this type of this will come outside external wall of a room. They may be square, split, circular, polygonal, or any shape, right? This is played. This will look like this now, right? This is looking like this, and this is your wall, right? The projection start from the sill level or floor level. Okay, this is an sill level or floor level means at this bottom. Okay, they may start. It depends on the condition or requirement. They admit more light, increase opening area, provide ventilation, and improve the appearance of the building. It may increase the appearance of the building, and it will give the extra light and opening in a room. Right? Next one. Yes, you can see the bay window. Okay, one more example just for your confirmation. Just I have just uploaded another image to understand better. You can see the window came outside of the main wall of the building, right? You can see here. Okay, so this is a frame. This is fully glazed. This is fully glazed. What? Bay window. Next, dormer window. First of all, this type of window is placed where the sloping roof is used. Window are provided on sloping roof. You can see the in the sketch. So why they will provide? To admit light and air to rooms which are constructed within or below below the roofs, right? Below the roof slopes, right? If you use the sloping roof, what will happen? The extra ventilation if you required, then in that condition they will use the dormer window. Okay, you can see the sketch and you can understand easily. This is fully glazed. This is fully glazed, and they are used like this, perpendicular, right? This is like a triangle. Okay, yes, you can see another sketch of the dormer window, right? This is a main sloping slope roof. In that they have provided in this direction, in this direction, in this direction. So these are the, 1 minute. So these are the dormer windows. These are the dormer windows. Next is French window, right? So we can't say this is a French window. This is a combination of door as well as window. You can see both, right? You can see both. Here there is an door, right? Sliding door, and it may be revolving door, any type of door with the extra what window. Okay, this type of door or window provided where you will use for villas as well as for bedrooms. If you want an exact view, if you want to see an view, agar aapko view dekhna hai, lake view ya jungle view kuch bhi dekhna hai, to courtyard aapka jo passage hai wahan pe isko provide karte hai for extra light as well as for extra ventilation. Okay, next is pivoted window. So this type of pivoted window is provided at the majorly at the toilets as well as the public buildings, right? Where the toilets are provided, in that condition it will use. So how it is constructed? So there is a frame, right? You can see there is a frame that we call it as head, and with the jamb, right? This surface we call it as jamb, and this is sill, right? This is sill, SILL. And at there is a pivot hinge. There is a pivot hinge, and this shutter, or we can say this window shutter, is just pivoted or fitted with this pivot. And this is the top roll. When we draw this shutter, it will look like this. Okay, either it may be fully paneled or half glazed or half paneled, depends on the requirement. And this is catchy means this is for locking purpose, right? You can just push here and you can just lock also, locking arrangement. So this type of windows shutters are allowed to swing around the pivots. You can rotate in this direction. windows either horizontally pivoted or vertically pivoted. Window either in this direction or in this direction. Okay. Next one, corner window. Right, corner window. So these windows are provided at corner of the window. The name itself, we can say, it has two faces in two perpendicular direction. Okay, this is one direction and this is another direction. In two different perpendicular direction, they will provide the corner window. So why they will be used? In which condition it will use? It will give extra light and air, and also elevation also improved. Right, elevation also improved by corner window. You can see, yes, you can see another sketch here. So this is complete assembly, we call it as and corner window. So you can see how beautiful it looking by providing the corner window. The elevation also improved of the building, right? Next is gable window. In sloping roof, okay, जहाँ पे भी sloping roof रहता है ना, वहाँ पे entrance में या end portion में जो भी हम window provide करते हैं, उसको हम gable window बोलते हैं. So okay, this type of at the slope, right? So at the end portion or starting portion, they will provide then gable window. Okay, you can see this is an gable window. This is an gable window. Thank you, friends. So thanks for your thanks for watching our all videos, as well as please subscribe our channel, like, comment and share, and please join our Telegram channel to watch as well as the latest videos like this, and to get all the current affairs as well as the static GK in our study group, that is Civil with Sudhir Telegram group. Thank you, my dear friends and my dear students. Dhanyavaad.